Hey y'all, hey, Erica with Time to Shrink. It is time to talk meal planning. This is week two of our January No Spend Challenge, where we're trying to eat everything from our pantry, fridge, and freezer. We gave ourselves a limit of $25 to $50 a week for food necessities, but we're trying to keep that as low as possible. So I'm gonna bring you in. I've got my meal planner all ready. I'm gonna show you what we're planning to eat. If you go up above to the iCards, or down below in the description, I will put a link to this series. In the first video of this series, I did take you through my entire house and show you all of the pantry food, all of the fridge and freezer food, and kind of tell you what our plan is. So now I'm gonna pull you down, show you my meal planner that I use, and show you how I am planning my week. I had a couple people request that I talk to you about what I'm planning to eat on my Squeaky Clean Keto Challenge as well for lunches and breakfast. So I'm gonna give you some ideas on that as well. All right, let's look at it. So this is the meal planner that I use. You can use any meal planner that you want. I have this as a free printable at mysouthernketokitchen.com. So if you're interested in this printable, you're welcome to go print it out for free. I'm actually working on a bunch of other printables and maybe an Etsy shop that I think would be fun because I just can't find exactly what I want. So I'm thinking about making them myself. So if y'all are interested in those might be coming up in an Etsy shop soon. But what I do is at the top, I just kind of put out what we're planning for the week and then I write out what's for dinner. So this week I went through my list back here. I have this list for January No Spend Month. I've listed out all the different meals I could think of to eat. We won't necessarily eat them in this order, but as we eat them, I cross them out. So for instance, we made barbecue nachos, we made a meatloaf, we made hamburgers and hot dogs. I've crossed out all of those things. And then I looked at this and went through my pantry, fridge, and freezer again to see what we might want to do for this week. My total budget for the month that I'm giving myself was $150 at Costco and $100 at the other stores split, so a total of $250 for the month. So far, we're doing really, really well with that, y'all. And then I also kind of planned out what I might do for breakfast, lunches, and snacks for my family. So there is that, just some egg casseroles, I could eat that as well. Some bacon and sausage, I could eat that as well. They have a bunch of different frozen things in the freezers, and leftovers are big lunches for all of us, me included. And then snacks, tortillas and dips, nuts, for me, bars if I'm gonna have a snack, or pork rinds. And then I just wrote stuff left in the cabinets. Like whatever they scavenge for, that's what they have for lunches and snacks. And my kids are teenagers, so they're totally able to do that. So that was what I did originally. Then we're gonna come over here and I plan out what's for dinner, and I also plan out what I'm gonna do for meal prep. So for meal prep this week, I was gonna make buffalo chicken dip. I was gonna do a chorizo egg casserole. I did not get that done. I was gonna make some bacon, haven't done that yet either. I did make the tomato sauce and the coleslaw, and I also chopped up and prepped a bunch of chicken. So Monday night, we're gonna have chicken bog with rice. That is definitely not a keto low carb meal, but if I serve it over collie rice for me, I don't know. I haven't made chicken bog ever, truthfully, but it was something that my son and his girlfriend wanted to have, so we're gonna make that. It is definitely a southern dish. I've eaten it many times, but I've never made it. So we're gonna make that on Monday night. Tuesday night, I'm gonna do meatballs and tomato sauce for the kids because it will be super easy, and I have yoga that night, which I didn't even write it up there, but on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have yoga. And for me, I'm going to pre-make, before I go to yoga, a shrimp fried rice that I can just heat up when I come home. And then I'll probably eat on that for lunches for a couple of days. Wednesday is a pretty full day, so we're just gonna do some grilled marinated chicken. I'm just gonna pull that out of the freezer and then serve it with some frozen veggies. Thursday, I flip these days actually. Thursday, I have yoga again. On Thursday, I have yoga again, and I like to do like fish or things I can do quick in the air fryer or things that have already been meal prepped that I heated up. So I'm planning to do like a lemon and capers fish with some collie rice. Everybody likes that. I can come home from yoga and make that in 10 minutes. Super, super easy. And then Friday, I have time to play around. I don't have anything scheduled. So I am gonna try and make a duck. I have duck. I've never made duck in my entire life. I'm not sure why I bought it, but I did, and it's been in the freezer for a little while. So I'm gonna pull that out to thaw probably tomorrow so it gets
fully thawed because it's a whole duck, and I'm gonna play with that on Friday. I don't know if I'll be able to make it, y'all. I don't know why I thought I could be that adventurous, but I found a lot of Pinterest recipes. It doesn't look hard, so I don't know. I've only ever had duck at like a high-end restaurant, so I'm very terrified. But we shall see. And then Saturday and Sunday, I didn't plan anything. I usually plan 2 days of leftovers. So one of these days may be a leftover day. And the other day, I don't know. But I don't always plan out exactly what night meals are going to be. I try to, but there's definitely flexibility in that. And then I made my grocery list. And my plan was to only spend $25. I found a really good sale on chicken breast. So I ended up spending about $37, I believe, because I bought quite a bit of chicken breast. But I think it was worth it because we will run out of meat this month. I know we will. We're not completely stocked. So I'll have that chicken to pull on. So this was our grocery list. And then, like I said down here, I had budgeted $25, but I spent about $37 because of the chicken. And then I also kind of just wanted to show y'all how I keep track of my spending. So what I do is I use the Jordan Page method. I don't know if you're familiar with her, but she does a lot of frugal videos and budgeting videos and things like that. And what she does is she takes an envelope and she does the grocery budget and then an everything else budget. And she breaks it up by month, so one week at a time. And then whatever your balance is, you break that into fours, and that's how much you have to spend each week. And then what I do is I write down what I spent at the grocery store here, and it keeps a running tally. And then over here, whatever we spend on anything else. I gave us $300 this month because we're trying to spend very minimally. And then I wrote down how we went with that. We did get two pretty big expenditures this month, but I am not gonna take that out of this budget. I'm gonna take it out of another budget. We have been looking for a piece of furniture. I will show it to you here in just a second, for quite a while. And also my son needed like everything in clothes. So we're taking some of our stimulus money to do those two things, and the rest is gonna go to savings. So even though I wrote them here, this $500 expenditure and $600 expenditure did not come out of this. And then I just use this envelope to help me keep track day to day. So I also write gas expenditures on here, and then I kind of started writing what I'm doing with some of that stimulus money. I was planning to save it all, but we just came across a couple things. Actually, let me show you. The lighting is not great because it's evening, but let me see if I can get this to focus. Okay, so this is my spot in the kitchen. If you have followed me, I usually had a desk right here, and that's my seat that I like to sit on all the time. But we were needing some more storage, and we found this piece. We've been looking for like a year for a piece to go here. The desk was just not, it seemed like it would be functional, but it wasn't. We needed storage more than we needed desk space. So we bought this at Costco for like four, I think it was $500 by the time you paid taxes. But I'm really happy with it. I like it a lot. It's got a lot of storage space. So now I just need to figure out what I'm going to store here and rearrange some storage. All right, let me show you the grocery haul real quick. Y'all, I am back from Aldi. I spent $37. Our goal is to not spend more than $50, but I really wanted to spend more like $25. But I found some deals, and I know we'll need more meat by the end of the month, so I went ahead and got them. So let me show you. This chicken is $5 a pack. Chicken breast fillets, they're supposed to be like Chick-fil-A style. They're not anywhere close to Chick-fil-A, but they're pretty tasty, and my son has been on a kick with these. My youngest is very, very picky about what he eats, and he'll eat these. So I did get him two of these, so that was $10 of our budget right there. And then this beef, this is not beef, Erica, this is chicken. The chicken was on sale, a $2 off package and a $1 off package. I needed just this much for a chicken bog this week, but I know that I'm gonna end up needing some later in the month. This would have been the end of our chicken after I make chicken bog with this one. So I got this whole thing of chicken breast. I'm gonna go ahead and break it down and freeze it in the portions that I want it, but I went ahead and got that. Again, for chicken bog that we are making this week, I needed some chicken bone broth, and I like this Simply Nature brand. It is organic, it's non-GMO, and I like to do bone broth versus chicken broth because it's a little more flavorful and it has some protein. I got some garlic. I'm not real sure why I picked this up because I do have some garlic in the refrigerator that I could be using right now, but whatever. Got some cream cheese to make buffalo dip for my family. I got two bacon, chopped kit bacon Caesar salads, and then one thing of coleslaw. So that is what we got this week for groceries from Aldi, and we spent a total of $37.90.
All right, y'all, that was our grocery haul and meal plan for this week. Next Saturday, you will see a what's for dinner video, and I will share with you everything that we actually ate. And then the next Sunday, we'll be back to another meal plan. So that's kind of what this month is looking like. All right. Bye, y'all. Be blessed.